Welcome. Environmental Studies, 5th Standard, Lesson 11, Nature of Matter, Part 2, Question Answers. Question 1. What is matter? Answer. Matter is anything that occupies space and has weight. Question number 2. Take the properties of matter. Answer. Properties of the matter are matter occupies space, matter has weight. Question number 3. How can you prove that matter occupies space? Answer. Place a glass beaker completely filled with water on a plate. Immerse a stone tied to thread slowly into the beaker. Some water in the beaker flows out and collects in the plate. This shows matter occupies the space. Question number 4. Name 3 forms of the matter. Answer. 3 forms of matter are solids, liquids and gases. Question number 5. Think and group these materials in their particular column. Buttermilk, candle, curd, kerosene, charcoal, honey, piece of brick, smoke. Answer. Solid. Piece of brick and candle. Liquid, buttermilk, kerosene, honey, smoke, charcoal or gas. Fill in the blanks with suitable words. Answer. Ice cube on heating, water. Water on heating, vapor. Vapor on cooling, water. Water on cooling, ice. Question number 7. Write 2 factors that density depends. Density depends on 2 factors. Mass of each particle, compactness of the arrangement of these particles. Question number 8. Mention other classification of the matter. Answer. The other classification of the matter are elements, compounds, mixtures. Question number 9. Explain buoyancy. Answer. When an object is immersed in water, it exerts a downward force on the water, and the water in turn exerts upward force or upthrust on the object, and the upthrust is equal to the mass of the liquid displaced. This is upthrust that keeps the body afloat. This upthrust is called the force of buoyancy. Multiple choice questions. Question number 1. Atomic theory was proposed by Kannada, John Dalton, Lavoisier, Berzelius. Kannada. Question number 2. A particles that held tightly in liquids, plasma, solids, gases. Answer is particles are held tightly in solids. It is. Okay, it is not gases. Liquids have definite volume but not definite shape. Definite shape and definite volume. Define definite volume, definite shape. Definite shape and definite volume. Liquids have. They have definite volume, not definite shape. Okay. The quantity of the matter in the given object or the substance is called buoyancy, density, pressure, mass. Pressure. The quantity of matter in the given object or the substance is called mass. It is. Pressure is wrong. Fill in the blanks. Law of conservation of matter is given by the scientist John Dalton. Second one, SI unit of the mass is kilogram. Third one, SI unit of density is kilogram per cubic meter. The elements are classified into metals and non-metals. Mass is quantity of the matter in the given object or substance. Pressure is the force exerted on a unit area. Volume is the amount of the space occupied by the matter. Plasma is the fourth state of matter. Ninth one, visible matter is made up of invisible particles. Answer the following. Question number 1. How are the particles arranged in solids and liquids? In solids, particles are held together closely in a compact manner in liquids, and particles are close together but they are not arranged in an order as in case of solids. Question number 2. Gases have no definite shape and volume. Why? Gases. Gas particles in the container move independently in all directions, so it has no definite shape and volume. What is sublimation? Answer, the change of state from solid to vapor or from vapor to solid without passing through the liquid state is called sublimation. Question number 4. State the law of conservation of matter. Answer, the law of conservation of matter states that the quantity of the matter in the universe never varies. That is, the quantity of the matter remains the same regardless of what change it undergoes. Question number 5. Define density and pressure. Answer, density is the amount of the mass contained in a unit volume. Pressure is the force exerted on the unit area. Question number 6. Define change of state of that substance. Answer, this change of solid substance into liquid substance and then into the gases on heating is called the change of state of that substance. Please subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon and save the playlist. Thank you very much. Bye bye.